is so beautiful. I bought it for my wife. It has a woman in the supporting a tree. It just sounds like life starts from a woman. I also want to pray together with all of you for all the victims of recent shootings in the U.S. Because we all, I believe we all believe in the same thing, and we all believe that hatred is not an answer for anything. Compassion, understanding, love and kindness, empathy is what the answer is. That's what each of us should believe in, and we should all hopefully do our part that it doesn't happen again. I did my small part. I'm a teacher, I'm a writer. I wrote a small piece for Statesman Journal in the morning today by the title called United We Stand in the Aftermath of a Decline of a American Value. And I reiterated in that piece time and again how I, as an immigrant, like my brothers who are here today, believe in American value of equality, value of liberty, value of justice, value of diversity. And look at us, and look at you. In many countries, even today, unfortunately, this won't be possible. People won't show up to listen to different religions. But this one value we can work towards. I teach law at Lamont University. I'm also associate director for their Center for Dispute Resolution. And I direct their LLM, a master's in law program in dispute resolution. But I'm most proud of one achievement in life. I will be teaching, starting next semester, for the first time ever on the West Coast, a course called Cross-Cultural Dispute Resolution in a law school. A course that I developed 4 years ago. I started teaching about 4 years ago, and I just love it that law school allowed me to offer that course, because look, even a law school is opening up to different cultures, understanding, empathy. Isn't that what we should all hope for?
Yes.
Mr. Lispet reminded me of a book by one of the famous authors I remember called Richard Lispet. I think he's from Stanford, who wrote a book called How Easterners and Westerners Think Differently and Why. What a wonderful book, because the book doesn't place blame or judgment on any Easterner or Westerner. It just says we just happen to think differently and we need to understand why, instead of saying that I know the answer. Just ask why. So many answers in on earth can get resolved if we just ask each other why. Today we showed you the picture of Golden Temple for Sikhism. The Golden Temple, actually the foundation stone, was laid down by a Muslim, Mian Mir, and one of our gurus made sure that a person of different religion, equally important religion, lays down the foundation stone, so it doesn't belong. The religion doesn't, it's not, you're not special, you're not the best religion, you're all equal. Let's bring a scholar from a different religion, a famous Muslim saint who laid the foundation stone. Other story about Golden Temple you should know is, Golden Temple is lower than ground level. If you ever been to Amritsar, India, and you go to Golden Temple, it has four doors, so persons from all walks of life are welcome, but it's lower than ground level. And the reason is, if you want to find God, lower yourself. Stay humble. Be humble. That's the meaning of Sikh. Sikh means a learner, and you're supposed to be learners forever. The second principle, the only other principle I share right now, is someone said, use the word when I was a kid. And I'll say, I'm still a kid. So I have my elders here who have way more wisdom than I have. So when the question answers come on Sikhism, I'm going to take their, I'm going to be their shadow. They're also here to keep a check on me, you know. So I'm going to introduce my friends just very quickly. Sardar Bahadur Singh, the guy in the red turban, he's the president of Salem Sikh Temple. And he draws all here. Sardar Jagmohan Singh, he's the secretary of Sikh Temple. We have our friends Harjeet Singh and our youngest friend Amrit Singh. So what's common in all these names? Singh. And you should ask, why Singh? The reason is, one of our gurus wanted to eradicate caste system, inequality, and he said the best way would be that's our 10th Guru Gobind Singh Ji, the best way would be have a same surname. And so every Sikh man is supposed to have Singh as a surname, so you're all equal, no higher, no lower, regardless of caste, color, creed, class. And all the women will have a beautiful name called Kaur, which means princess. So she's your princess, treat her like a princess. Lastly, I will close by saying the last word of our daily Sikh prayers, which we call Ardas. And it ends by saying, Sarbat Tapala Hove. And Sarbat is, may everyone be blessed. Not just me, not just my family, not just my tribe, not just my town, not just my state, not just my county, not just my country. Everyone be blessed. I think we'll all should believe it. Thank you for having us here.